Hi friends, as per my second video for the SS Spark Scala application into the IntelliJ, I am here back and I will tell you how you are going to create the Spark Scala application. Very first applications, the normal applications which is known as the creation of the RDD. Okay, as we know, RDD can be created into three different formats, either by simply the taking the data or by reading one text files or by existing RDD can be modified into the new RDD. So that is the second matter. Now, till now we have seen that how we can install the IntelliJ IDEA and how we can set up this build tool SVT with the some of the dependency, and I am using the Spark version as the 2.44. Now the very first thing what you need to do, how we are going to create your Scala application to create the RDD over here. So simply you need to come to this main source, main Scala, and here right click on this Scala, go to this new and click on this package. Okay, initially you will not find this any package I have created just now, so you can create any package name where your code is going to be stored. In my case, I have created this com.dataedge. You can create the name and give the name according to your choice. Once you have this project ready, what you can do, you need to create the Scala applications. So just simply right click over here, select new, and here you can see I have the option like the Java class, Scala class. And very first time, the important point over here is that whenever you are creating and the project very first time into your machine, you will not come to see this Scala class option over here. Then what to do? I will tell you first that one, then we'll come to create the Scala class. So in this project only, you have to right click, and here you have to click on the add framework support. Okay, in my case I did it the Scala supports, because of that it is not showing over here, but in your case it will give you the Scala option over like here, Groovy, Kotlin, JVM and Maven. Sorry, so here also you will get the Scala. You can select on that one, and then you need to the version will be automatically detected. You need to click on the create. Once it is created, you need to click on this okay. Then after next time, if you click over here new and then Scala object, you will come to know that you are successfully having that option how to create the Scala class over here. So how you are going to create the Scala, that is the main matter over here. Now from this available menus, what you have to do, you have to select on this object class, okay, and give the name over here. So you can give the name according to your choice. So suppose I'm giving the name as the RDD create. Okay, you can give any specific name, whatever you are you want to give, or you can give like the create RDD, RDD creation, something like that. You can give any name, there is no issue on that one. Select, make sure that you have selected this object, and then you just hit enter or double click over there. So now you can see here inside this package one object class is created with the name RDD creation. What is the next step over here and how you are going to create the RDD? So before running any writing any step, what you have to do, you have to create the main method over here. That will be the entry point of your application. Type main and press Control plus spacebar. It will give you this suggestion. What you have to do, you have to click on this one, simply double click. Okay, main, and it is suggesting you the main method template. You can double click on that. So now you can see the main method is getting created. Now whatever the code you want to wish, you can write over here. Okay, how to create, how to read a file, like that. Okay, so let me give you the some quick idea over here how we can create the file. So here what we have to do, while working with the Spark Scala application, we need to create the Spark context object. Okay, that will be the entry point of any of the applications which is developed for the Spark. So a Spark context is the entry point for any applications developed using the Spark Scala. So this is the syntax, and this syntax will be same for each and every applications. Here what we are doing, using new Spark Conf, we are creating an a configuration. You need to give the Spark application name. You can give any name, okay? And then you need to set here the master. So master simply means where you want to run your applications, either it is running into your Hadoop cluster or with whether it is running in, running locally. So here the standard way is that we need to give the one value like this one, local, inside that one integer value. That integer value should be always greater than zero, which is nothing, which is telling nothing, but it is simply the number of the core of the CPU which is available into your machine. Okay. So no need to dig a lot on that part, but you have to see the syntax like this, how we are going to create the SC. Whenever you are running the Spark application and you are launching the Spark shell, you will get this SC by default created. But for our application into IntelliJ, we need to create it. And this is the way how we can create it. Now you can see it is giving us some suggestions, the red color one, whatever it is showing is the error. So if you highlight over here, it is saying that you need to import this one. Click on this one. Again, for this Spark context also, you need to import this one also. Now your Spark is configured successfully into your application for creation of the RDD. Now, as I was talking, there are multiple ways. This is the first way to create the RDD. What we can do, we can create one variable name at the data. You can take any name. And in the data, you can store either the array from 1 to 5 or something like that. You can store, okay. Or better, we can take like here, I'm going to modify this one, 1, 2, then 10,000. And that will be my to list. So here I have created one list of the value 1 to 1,000. And that will be stored into this data. Now from this data, how we are going to create the RDD? The very simple step is that by making use of this Spark context object, we have the parallelize method. In that we need to pass this data list. Once you pass this data list over here, it means your RDD is now created. Okay, and this is the syntax to simply just see the content. So data RDD dot for each method and println. Just execute this one. While running the Scala application into IntelliJ, it will take a couple of the seconds to run. As you can see internally down, it is showing some of the steps which is executing. Now you can see it is running on the top of the JDK only. Just wait for the result. These are the log warnings and other information for the application. You need to wait the time till it, you are seeing this code, exit code 0. Exit code 0 means it is running successfully. If it is exit code 1, it means you have some error into your application. And you can see these values from 1 to 1000 it has printed. So this is how we can create the RDD into Scala. I'm going to tell the second way to create the RDD. Second way. What you have to do, you have to again take one variable and you can take any name, RDD2, you can take the name. Then this way of creation of the RDD is by reading the text file. How you can read the text file into Scala? So sc dot, it is having couple of the methods like text file. We have the whole text file, so we are making use of the text file FA over here. And this one, you need to specify the location of the file where your data is present into your machine. So either you can read the file from the HDFS running Hadoop cluster, or you can provide the file locations from your local machine. In my case, I have created one folder over here, and you can see a lot of the data is available into this one. So I'm going to simply create the data by reading the either the JSON file. So I will read this JSON file now. Part R. So let me specify the location over here. Okay, then //. What is the name of that file? You can take any file, any format also. No need to specify only that JSON and other things only. First, you need to try with the TXT file. So now what we did, we have already loaded the some text file into our RDD. So this is the second way to create the RDD. What we can do, how we are going to verify this one? So RDD2 dot. Here we have the methods like collect, for each, count, something like that. What we can do, we can make use of this count only to see how many records present into this one. Okay, so let me save it and run the application once again. Means if RDD2 is created, there will be some records present into that one, and for that we will take the count. Application is getting started. So execution error code is the exit 0. We'll see after 1000, right? We need to get the count value also. So we are not able to get the exact syntax. So what we can do, we can we'll comment this one. Okay, now you can simply check this one also. Or you can execute the show command. Not so. For each inside println, I'll pass. Means what are the content inside that file that is going to be displayed at the output. So save it and rerun. Wait for some couple of the second and you can see here that these many data are present into that JSON file and it has been successfully loaded. And by loading these JSON files, we have created the RDD and that all these JSON files is getting printed. So this is how we can create the RDD by reading the from the text file. Now we have the third way to create the RDD. What is that third way? Means if we have any of the RDDs already created, from that RDD we will try to create the new RDD. How we can create that, that I am going to show you. So this is how RDD3 is going to be created. From where it is going to be created? So it is going to be created from this data _RDD. On that I'm going to apply the mapping function, map functions. And map functions, what it is going to do, whatever the value it is present, okay, that all values will be added 100 to it. Means first time 1 is there, so 101, second time 2, so 102, like that it will create the RDD and then it will display the result. So just run this application once again. Just wait. Exit code 0. Now we can see this one now. Yeah, we have the lot of the data from the second way. Then थर्ड वे ऑफ क्रिएशन ऑफ द आरडीटी. You can see earlier the value was starting from 1, 2, 3 like that. Now it has started from the 101 and it will end over here 1100. So this is how we are going to create the RDD into Spark using Scala. So totally we have the three way to create the RDD and we have seen each and every way. So stay tuned for my next video. Thank you.